This episode of the John LeBang Show is brought to you by Banger for President 2016.
Yeah, when the two-party system leaves you feeling ill deep down, then you only have one option.
Vote for none of the above, man,
or else you'll get the runs.
Banger 2016.
I'm John LeBang, and I approve this message.
And welcome back, folks. And with the holiday upon us and summer underway, and with all the terrorist attacks going on, the United States government and other governments across the world were telling their people that security is now heightened and we should be on alert because there might be a terrorist attack that possibly could happen around the 4th of July, which is Independence Day, or right through the summer, maybe even on the anniversary of 9/11. And people are wondering, what ways could the terrorists hit us next? We just seen that they hit Bangladesh. So obviously the terrorists out there are hitting wherever they possibly can, any soft targets, because they're cowards. And because they're cowards, that's how they attack civilization, is to attack the people directly. But they may be finding other ways of killing us besides suicide bombers. Because eventually, if they have too many suicide bombers, they're not going to have ranks anymore if they can't replenish as fast as they're bombing people. So they're going to hit soft targets, and they're going to cut back on the suicide bombers in favor of, well, what every other army is looking to do, and that's to have killer robots working for terrorist organizations. As I read from an article, terrorists are working to build armies of artificial intelligent robots capable of slaughtering vast numbers of innocent civilians.
I'll be back.
That's the terrifying claim from a piece of authoritative research published by the United Nations, which recently held an urgent meeting to discuss the threat posed by murderous machines.
Fuck you.
Experts from dozens of countries convened in Geneva to consider the grim implications of lethal autonomous weapon systems.
That's why I'm going to kill you last.
Acronym LAWS. Which are capable of killing without needing to have humans at the control.
I lied.
So the terrorists are now going to contact Google or somebody like Google and get those autonomous robots for them as well.
I'll be back.
So ISIS and Al-Qaeda are now going to become the Trade Federation.
I'll be back.
These sort of machines are famous from films like The Terminator, but the reality killing machine robots could be anything from a smart landmine to a drone fitted with machine guns.
Don't disturb my friend. He's dead tired.
The UN wants to set strict guidelines governing the use of killer robots to make sure they don't end up being used as indiscriminate weapons of war, because terrorists will follow the rules of the United Nations.
Really hungry.
Whilst these systems of killer robot machines might be available to technologically advanced countries in the initial phase,
fuck you, asshole,
it is likely it will proliferate as time goes on.
I'll be back.
Terrorists are in fact actively seeking such systems because they're probably running out of suicide bombers.
Let off some steam.
Because eventually, even the dumbest people on Earth have to realize that your sons and daughters are being killed so that other people can have power. Illegal transfers might mean that laws would become available on non-state actors or terrorists.
I'll be back.
With the world on the edge of robotic revolution, as well as the radio revolution, this is expected to see machines take on human roles and potentially cause unemployment on a truly catastrophic scale.
I'll be back.
Are you listening, ladies and gentlemen, what they're telling you? Not only are robots, which companies are starting to phase in right now, going to take your jobs at such a high level that people are going to face catastrophe.
That's why I'm going to kill you last.
But while they're facing catastrophe, groups like Al-Qaeda and ISIS will have their own robots to come take you out.
I lied.
Maybe they'll work with the government. You let the terrorist group take out the people, and then eventually you take out the terrorist group when enough people are killed.
I'll be back.
How's that for a conspiracy theory? The UN report continued. Due to an inherent dual-use character of many robotic technologies, many systems originally intended for civilian purposes could easily be modified to serve military functions. And I'm telling you, really, robotics were pushed by the military. It was military first, because the military has the money from the governments. So-called robotics that are for civilian use are far less sophisticated than any of the military robots, and they haven't been around as long as the military's versions of robotics. So now that's something else we got to worry about. But at least, you know, at least if we see a giant Terminator heading into a nightclub, say in Orlando,
I'll be back.
It'll be easier to spot. Unless they put skin on it and he looks like Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Don't steal, my friend. It's dead time.
So maybe, ladies and gentlemen, if you see Arnold Schwarzenegger walking into a gay bar in Orlando, start running. Because he's probably the Terminator coming for you.
Right now, I'm really hungry.
Short segment here, folks, as we move through this broadcast. In the second half hour, we're going to talk about the Red Cross and racism, and how the two are linked. It's something you don't want to miss.
I'll be back.
You're listening to the John LeBang Show.
It's better than some tie stick, man.
Yes, and I bet you're loving it.
Hey, pass that over.